Hello everyone. Last time we have explained about three types of terrestrial ecosystems such as forest ecosystem, grassland ecosystem and the desert ecosystem. Today we are going to explain about the second type of ecosystem such as aquatic ecosystem, and this includes mainly three types of aquatic ecosystem such as marine ecosystem, brackish water or estuarine ecosystem and the freshwater ecosystems. So aquatic ecosystems includes the variety of water resources which are available on the planet Earth, which are used by the different type of living organisms, and where they grows and develops. So the aquatic ecosystems are classified into freshwater ecosystem, and this includes rivers, ponds, streams, lakes and the wetlands, and the marine ecosystem includes seas and oceans. And third one, that is brackish water or estuarine ecosystem, includes the estuaries or the river deltas which are in a close communication with the sea water. So these aquatic ecosystems provides us a wealth of natural resources such as the fish, variety of fish fauna, or a tremendous wealth of fish fauna which is present in the aquatic ecosystems, may be freshwater, brackish water or marine water, that forms a good quality or type of wealth for the mankind. They provide us fishes, prawns, crabs, lobsters, bivalve murus, etc., and these are usually used for the purpose of food for the human consumption, as they are rich source of the proteins. So the whatever the byproducts of the aquatic ecosystems such as fishes, prawns, crabs, lobsters or bivalve mollusk, they serve as a source of protein food. Then big dams can be used for the production of electricity and for the purpose of agricultural irrigation. Now man is over utilizing these ecosystems, hence exploiting their natural resources. Overfishing leads to the fall in the fish catch. So even though there are different type of aquatic water resources in the form of fresh water, brackish water or marine water resources, the modern man is utilizing these natural resources or exploiting these natural water resources for the purpose of fishing, and excessive fishing has led into the reduction in the fish catch or the quantity of the fish catch present in the respective type of water resources. We know water is important component of all our ecosystems. Water is very important component of all our ecosystems. Several ecosystems exist in a fresh water and marine or salt water. So out of total 71% water resources, only 3% fresh water on the earth is a source of fresh water for the people all over world. Means out of 71% of the water resources, only 3% is a fresh water, and rest of the percentage, that is about 68% of the water present on the earth is a marine or salty, and that can't be used for any purpose any other purpose except the fisheries, or the except as a fishery source. So this cannot be used. Salty water cannot be used for a drinking purpose or any other purposes. And only 3% of the water present on the earth's surface that is composed or containing or that is occurring in the fresh water resources, and that is only the source of fresh water for the people or the human being to use for either drinking or for the irrigation purpose all over world. The plants, animals and microorganisms live in water. Plants, animals and microorganisms live in water and forming the biotic component or the biotic factors of the aquatic ecosystems or the different water resources. The animals are adapted to live in different habitats with abiotic factors such as clarity, salinity, oxygen contents, pH, mud, light, etc. Though mud, gravel or rocks of the bed influence its plant and animal species composition. So there are different type of water resources or the water bodies, and which serves as separate ecosystems, and each of the ecosystem is having variable species of the plants, animals and microorganisms, and this is due to the variable or the different type of abiotic factors which are present in these waters. And these abiotic factors are clarity, salinity, oxygen contents, pH, mud, light, etc. So these are the abiotic factors or the parameters differently present or variably present in the different water resources, but out of which the mud, gravel or rock of the bottom or the bed in the respective water resource influences its plants and animal species or the composition of the biotic factors or the biotic community. Some freshwater ecosystems are stagnant or running water ecosystems. Means there are two type of freshwater ecosystems, either stagnant like pond, lake or dams, and the running water ecosystems including different rivers, streams. So there are two type of freshwater ecosystems, either stagnant or running water ecosystems, that is lytic and lotic, lentic and lotic ecosystems or waters. Wetlands are also forming the special ecosystems in which water level changes dramatically in different seasons. So wetlands will also form the freshwater ecosystems as a shallow water with aquatic vegetation and forms ideal habitat for the certain species of the fish, crustacean and the aquatic birds. So wetlands, which might be a seasonal, which may have different depth as per the seasons. So wetlands are the special ecosystems in which water level changing dramatically in different seasons, and these ecosystems or the wetland ecosystems expands as a shallow water level aquatic vegetation that will form a shallow water with aquatic vegetation and forms the ideal habitat for the fish, crustacean and the aquatic birds. Marine ecosystems are seas with a highly saline water. We know the marine water or the sea water ecosystem, they are having highly saline or salty water. In a brackish water ecosystems, water is less saline. In a brackish water or estuarine or river deltas, which are present at the junction of the seas and rivers. So river where joins to the seas, that forms a shallow and a large area, shallow waters and large area which are situated at the junction of river and seas, and thus forming a mixture of the fresh water and the salty or saline water of the seas, and thus salinity of the river deltas or brackish waters or the estuary is less saline or less salty. Coral reefs are very rich species found in the shallow seas. Coral reefs are in a large quantity and are present in the shallow waters of the seas. For example, in Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Gulf of Kutch. So, Andaman and Nicobar Islands and the Gulf of Kutch, where there are tremendous species of the coral reefs which are found in the shallow waters of the Andaman Nicobar Islands and the Gulf of Kutch, representing the brackish water ecosystems, and are rich in coral reefs and forming a well developed aquatic ecosystem in the brackish water ecosystems such as Andaman and Nicobar Islands and the Gulf of Kutch. So, this is the introduction regarding the aquatic ecosystems or the overall information regarding the aquatic ecosystems, where there are mainly three types of aquatic ecosystem, that is marine water aquatic ecosystem, including seas and oceans. So, we know about 68% of the water resources which are present on the earth surface, that contributes seas and oceans, and having a salty or highly saline water present in these resources, that is seas and oceans. And rest of 3%, that is fresh water resources, which are the inland water resources. Inland water resources which are in the form of large or small rivers, streams, lakes, ponds, dams, etc., and that are containing the fresh water, and where the aquatic fauna which is adapted for the freshwater habitat. So, and third one, that is the brackish water or river deltas or the estuaries, which are situated at the junction of rivers and seas or oceans, that forms the shallow waters having less saline water, where there is a junction of fresh water rivers and the seas, and that's why the salinity of the estuarine water or the brackish water is less saline or less salty, and thus there are three type of aquatic ecosystems: one, that is freshwater ecosystem, brackish water ecosystems, and the marine or salty water ecosystems. So there are three type of waters, and on that basis there are three types of aquatic ecosystems, that is the marine water, fresh water, and the estuarine or the brackish water. But all these three type of aquatic water resources have their different species of the plants, animals, and the microorganism. So, each of the water resource will have its biotic community in the form of aquatic flora, fauna, and the microorganisms which are adapted or suited to the respective water habitat, but providing the large quantity of the fish, then crabs or crustaceans, prawns, lobsters, then different type of mollusk, maybe pearl oysters or the bivalve mollusk, which are edible oysters. So, there is a tremendous wealth of the aquatic fauna and flora which is useful for the mankind. So there are mainly three type of aquatic ecosystems, that is the marine, fresh and the estuarine ecosystems, that will explain separately in a detail also. In brackish water ecosystems, if we observe the brackish water ecosystem or the estuarine water ecosystems, there are mangrove forests are present in a river deltas at the junction of river and seas. If we went to the Mumbai, that is a west region of western region of the Maharashtra, we can see there are several estuarine ponds or lakes present on about or around the Mumbai of Maharashtra, where there are large quantity of mangrove forest, and that forms the brackish water ecosystems. And whatever the leaves of the mangroves that falls in the shallow waters of the estuarine ponds of the Maharashtra or in Arabian Sea, in Maharashtra or at Mumbai, we can see there are large quantity of the mangrove forest, and these mangrove leaves will fall down into the shallow waters of the estuarine ponds, and that will form a ideal condition or the ecosystem for the growth of the aquatic organisms or the fishes. That is, that may be phytoplankton, zooplankton, or number of aquatic invertebrates together with the fish fauna present in the brackish water ecosystem. But brackish water ecosystem mainly composed of mangrove forest, and these are present in the river deltas, and these are world's most productive ecosystems in terms of the biomass production. So this contains a large quantity of biomass, that is in a quantity of the with respect to the weight or its volume, with respect to its weight or volume, that is a biomass of the total group of organisms or the plants present in the brackish water ecosystem. And thus the mangrove forest of the brackish water ecosystem forms the most productive ecosystems in terms of the biomass production. The largest swamps are in the Sundarbans in the deltas of the Ganges, means Ganga River. So Ganga River, which joins to the sea water, where there are brackish water ecosystem called as a Sundarban. So Sundarban, which is a brackish water ecosystem and present at the delta of the Ganga River, where it joins to the sea water. Then lake ecosystems, it is again a type of freshwater ecosystem. It has a large number of algae, aquatic algae are the producers, and they derive the energy or solar energy from the sun, and the aquatic plants playing the important role, aquatic plants plays the important role in the lake ecosystem. So the lake ecosystem, it is a freshwater ecosystem, and it consists of large number of algae, aquatic algae, and are serve as or acts as the producers, as they derive the energy from the sun or the sunlight from the sun, and utilizing it for the purpose of process of photosynthesis and producing food in the form of carbohydrate, utilizing the carbon dioxide, sunlight, chlorophyll pigment, and producing the carbohydrates, which will form a building block or the important material of the plant bodies. So aquatic plants playing important role in the lake ecosystem. The microscopic organisms consume algae. Microscopic organism means a zooplankton. The microscopic organisms, that is zooplankton, consume algae in the form of phytoplankton. So, whatever the abiotic factors or the nutrients, whether it's a variety of minerals or elements or the organic and inorganic nutrients which are present in the lake ecosystem, that is used first by the phytoplankton or the aquatic algae, and which is then used by the microscopic organisms like a zooplankton, that is means these microscopic algae or the microphyte or macrophyte, that is the aquatic algae which is used as a food by the phytoplanktons or the microscopic organisms from the lake ecosystem. Fishes are the herbivores which are also feeding onto the algae and the aquatic weeds. So whatever the fish fauna or the fish species present in the lake ecosystem, that are also utilizing these phytoplankton or the aquatic algae as a food and grows well in the lake ecosystem. So herbivore type of fishes which are utilizing the aquatic algae and aquatic weeds as a food. Snails are eaten by small carnivore fish. Snails, whatever the freshwater mollusk present in the lake ecosystem, that are used by the small carnivore fish, which are then consumed by large carnivorous fish. And thus, energy is transferred from herbivores to the carnivores. So, whatever the biotic and abiotic components or the factors present in the lake ecosystem that are utilized by the aquatic algae and animals, aquatic plants and animals that are utilizing the energy components, may be in the form of organic or inorganic materials, may be in the form of organic or inorganic materials, or may be in the form of biotic or abiotic factors present in the lake ecosystems that are utilized by the producers and the consumer category of the biotic components of the lake ecosystem. So, simply we can say there is a transfer of energy from abiotic factors to the biotic factors, means to the producers, and these producers in the form of aquatic algae or phytoplanktons that are used by the zooplanktons or herbivore fish or a carnivore fish, and thus there is a transformation of the energy or the transfer of energy from one trophic level to the other trophic level, whatever present in the lake ecosystem. So there is a energy transfer from the herbivores to carnivores. The waste of animals settle down the bottom of the lake. So after death of all the animals which are simply decomposed, which are settled down the bottom of the lake and which is then decomposed by the action of the bacteria, fungi, or might be consumed by the detritivores. So whatever the smaller invertebrates or the vertebrates which are present in the lake ecosystem that are utilizing these dead animals or dead organisms, and thus the waste of the animals which has settled down the bottom of the lake, that is also used by certain animals for the feeding purpose. And ultimately, the waste of the animals that are used by the certain detritivores, these are the small aquatic organisms which are feeding onto the dead and decaying organic matter or a detritus, and thus can form a part of the detritus food chain. and this acts as a nutrient material. So whatever the dead bodies of the aquatic plants and the animals after death that are settling down the bottom of the lake, and from where these are set free or decompose either through the process of decomposition or they are feeding by the detritus ores, and thus providing a source of nutrient material for the aquatic plants for their growth. So on the death and decomposition or its release in the bottom of the lake, that is again used back by the aquatic plants for their growth or the producers. During this process of during the process of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is used and oxygen is released, which is used by the aquatic animals. So this is what a energy transfer from abiotic factors to biotic factors, that is to the producers, then to the herbivores, then to the carnivores, and again after death, that is either decomposed in the bottom or that can be consumed by the detritus ores, and again released back in the abiotic component of the lake ecosystem. So during the process of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide, whatever is expelled or expired by the animals, that is used by the aquatic plants for the process of photosynthesis, and at the end of process of photosynthesis, that is in presence of sunlight, chlorophyll and the carbon dioxide, aquatic algae undergoes the process of photosynthesis and forming or producing the carbohydrates, and oxygen is released. So this oxygen is used by the animals, aquatic animals, for the respiration. Then stream and river ecosystems, stream and river ecosystems. So these are flowing water ecosystem. These are the flowing water ecosystems, and living forms or the species which are adapted to the different rates of the water flow. So the stream and river ecosystem, they have certain species of aquatic organisms or animals together with the fish species which are adapted to the different rate of water current or the rate of flow. In case of hill streams, when water passes from the hills down the foothill and having a rate of water flow is very rapid, having a rate of water flow and is very rapid. So in case of hill streams, water flow is very rapid, and even though the water flow is rapid, there are certain plants and burrowing animals like snails can withstand this rapid flow of the hill streams. So along the hill streams, water flow is very rapid, but still there are certain plants and certain burrowing animals like snails, they can withstand or can sustain even in a rapid water currents or rapid flow of waters from the hill streams. Then some species of the fishes, like mahseer. Mahseer is a type of fish that go upstream from the river to hill stream for a breeding purpose. So there are some species of the fishes which requires very clean and clear water for the breeding purpose, and that's why some species like of the fishes like mahseer go upstream from river where the water current is low or rate of water flow is less in a river, but There are some species of the fishes, they require very clean and clear water for breeding purpose, and thus the fish like masir goes upstream from river to the hill stream, river stream to the hill stream, because they need clean and clear water for breeding or reproductive activities. Due to deforestation, that is cutting of the trees from the hill regions, the streams become seasonal. Due to deforestation, hill streams become seasonal, means the hill streams become active or produced only during the monsoon season. So due to deforestation, hill streams become seasonal, and that may found only during, or that may appear only during the monsoon period, and this leads to the flash floods, and this leads to flash floods in the rain and shortage of water. Fauna and flora depends upon clarity, dissolved oxygen, rate of flow, and nature of their bed or the bottom. So, fauna and flora of the stream and river ecosystems where the water is flowing at different rates, and the species of the aquatic organisms, aquatic plants, or the aquatic fish species that are adopted for the stream currents at a different rate of flow, maybe low rate of flow or a rapid rate of flow. So, the fauna and flora depends upon the clarity of the water, oxygen contents, dissolved oxygen contents of water, then rate of flow, and nature of their bed. Nature of their bed may have mud or rock. So that also influences the species of aquatic organisms or the fishes in the respective stream or river ecosystems. So the beds may be sandy. Beds of the stream or river ecosystems may be sandy, may have sand, or a rocky or muddy, and accordingly they have their own species of the plants and animals. So aquatic plants and aquatic animals which are adopted for the respective habitats can only sustain or thrive or live or grow and establish better. So this is about the different type of aquatic ecosystems. So today we'll stop here, and next time we'll explain the detailed account of the pond ecosystem. So today with this we'll stop here. Thank you.